The new Windows 11 23 H2 update just dropped, and while I do have some new stuff to show you, you should be aware that this is basically just an enablement package of a bunch of features that were added in the previous update in September, which was pretty big, but not all those features were enabled by default. So if you saw my previous video about all those features, those are the main ones. I do have some stuff that I'm going to show you that I wasn't able to before, but just be aware there's not really too much new from there, but you can watch that afterwards if you haven't seen that yet. In any case, this update is going to be rolling out, but if you want to get it right now, you can go into the settings and then Windows Update, and then be sure to check get the latest updates as soon as they're available, and then check for updates and install whatever is there. And you'll know when you have it because you can go into the start menu and type in WinVer, like Windows version, and it should say 23H2, and then you'll know. All right, so first, here are some really cool features that I'm excited about that I was able to talk about, but not actually show you in the previous video because that update had not rolled out to me. The first being an improvement to the snipping tool. So you might already know that it's had the video recording feature for a little while, but now once you select a region to record the video, you'll have an option to add recording of the system audio and the microphone. You have an option to either mute or enable the recording of both of those and choose the microphone specifically. You can also go into the settings and choose whether recording the system and microphone will be enabled by default or if you just want to enable it each time. All right, next up, we have a feature in Microsoft Paint that, again, I didn't have before, but now I do, and that is CoCreator, or AI image generation, built right into Microsoft Paint. The first time you click this little icon to enable it, it will probably pop up a little tutorial thing giving a little bit of an explanation, and then you simply type in a prompt for what you want it to generate. You can also choose a style if you want, one of several, such as photographic or pixel art, or just none. Then once you click to generate it, it will generate a few options, and it will show up on the left side as you click each one, but you can also save the generations directly by simply clicking the down arrow and hitting save image from here. So it's not like you have to put it on the canvas and then save it. I should point out that this one does not use the latest DALL-E 3 model like the Bing online image generator does, which is also free. It seems to use the model which has been basically called DALL-E 2.5. It's better than the original DALL-E 2, but not as good as DALL-E 3. For example, it can't really do text. If we type in a prompt such as a smiling person holding a sign that says, wow, this is a cool sign, and then we have it generate some examples, and not exactly what I had in mind. So the faces are weird, you can see it can't do text, but if we then go into the Bing image generator, which uses DALL-E 3 with the same prompt, you can see that it's way better. It still messes up some words, but it's mostly right, and the faces look fine. If you have it generate enough, it'll make ones that are fully correct with the text. And it's also a lot better if it's only a couple words versus what I put. Still very cool though. I'm sure they're gonna update it eventually. They might just don't wanna get overwhelmed with so many Windows users using the new latest one, which probably takes more computing power. All right, now onto some new features in 23H2 that I don't believe I mentioned in the previous one. The first being a new system components app menu that separates out system apps versus installed apps. You can get to this from the bottom of the installed apps list or also through the system menu. And you can see there's a few here. For some reason, some that I've seen in other people's lists don't show up in mine, such as Notepad. Not really sure why that is. Maybe it's because I use the one that's updated from the Microsoft Store. Not sure. So that's one thing I'd be curious about. Let me know down in the comments if you guys see this same list or maybe you have more. Another thing though, also in the start menu, all apps list, you'll now see a system tag beneath those same apps, I believe. So same idea. Probably just to give people who aren't super familiar with Windows an idea of which ones came pre-installed and which ones might have been installed via, I don't know, like bloatware, stuff like that. Another little update, there's more languages now supported in the live captions feature. Off the top of my head, I remember there's Chinese, German, French, I believe. So you might be able to use that feature now, depending on where you live. Now next, originally Windows was supposed to get the new 3D emojis in this update, and I had them for a while, but apparently they went away again. I think apparently there was some kind of font rendering bug, so that might come back. I know I had it before, but just be aware of that. You're supposed to get it eventually. Next, a bit of a more advanced feature are dev drives. So you can get to this a couple places, such as going to system, and then for developers, and then create dev drive, though this might only be certain editions like Pro and Up, might not be in Home. I'm not super familiar, honestly, with how dev drives work. Apparently, it lets you create a volume that is specifically for development workloads, and it's somehow optimized for that case. So if you are a developer, maybe read more up on that. I know it has something to do with the new REFS, Resilient File System, that Windows has in like Pro for workstations, but is not by default yet. Finally, Windows will be replacing that chat icon that was in the taskbar with Microsoft Teams Free Edition, which I believe was already included with Windows, but now that's just gonna be the default thing for chat. I'm not super familiar with it, I've never used it, but if you see it go away, that's why. So yeah, like I said, mostly minor stuff. If you wanna see the real big main changes that might have been enabled with this update, then go and watch my previous video where I talked about all those features, and that's the bulk of the main really cool ones that you'll see. There's actually quite a few in there. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.